synchronization is a very important topic when we have to synchronize the two generator. There are three basic conditions which has to be satisfied, in which there is a one condition is your voltage, second is your phase. So whatever generator is coming on a load, or whatever incoming generator which is in phase with a running generator, and third one is a frequency, is a major component. And this is the three major component which has to always regulate. So here we gonna see how the synchronization takes place. Here is a PMS system, power management system. So power management system, we have a power management system. Automatic synchronization is also available. So if you have an auto start generator will start automatically as well as will come on load automatically. So this is one of which is way, but in case of if automatic operation fails or if there is a need of manual synchronization, then whatever thing has to be seen. Like we have to see whether voltage, phase and frequency, these three parameters of must be equal. So here we see synchro panel we have seen here kilowatt of generator number 1, generator number 3, generator number 2, generator number and 1. Now here is your frequency meter for generator 1 is bus for and 1 is for incoming generator number 1 and generator number 2. Second one is your again voltage for generator number running generator, and this is for incoming generator. This is a synchroscope. Synchroscope is a provided, so, and this is a dark lamp and bright lamp method. So both are alternative, optional is a provided. So we have a dark lamp, bright lamp as well as a synchroscope. So what is important property of the synchroscope, if the incoming generator is running fast, then this will light will always move faster and it will be clockwise direction. While if incoming generator is running slow, it will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So whatever the condition we want, the incoming generator should come in phase with the running generator, and frequency should be slightly more than the running generator. So whatever the delay will be caused during the starting, it will be get eliminated during the, because of this frequency. So we have to start generator vane between 11 o'clock position to 12 o'clock position. So synchroscope lamp must turn slowly in clockwise direction in a slow method. So we have to start, once we started in clockwise direction, so initially we have to start the generator, we have to ensure that whether voltage and frequency two parameter in phase or similar with the running generator. Once that is a confirm, then we'll have to start the synchroscope. See, this is a switch which is incoming generator, like say generator number 1, 2 or 3. Now if I say generator number 1 is running and we have to take a generator number 2 on sync, then we have to select the switch on generator number 2. Once we select generator number 2, now the light will start rotating. This lamp will continuously rotate and this three lamp will start glowing. Like the here most important condition is given that these two lamps should be on and this lamp should be off when we are doing synchronizing or when we are closing the switch ACB air circuit breaker of the incoming generator. Now say this is the synchroscope is running between 11 o'clock to 12 o'clock position. We have to close the ACB. Once we have got all the conditions satisfied, now check, keep one hand on ACB control. ACB control, as soon as the condition satisfied, that is two lamp are light on, 11 to 12 o'clock position has been reached. At the same time, we have to close the ACB, just close and release. Once it closes, generator will come on load automatically. Now the generator will symmetrically share the loads automatically. If there is a slight change in a frequency or a slight change in, we have to adjust the by means of a governor motor. This governor motor controls the RPM and hence we can vary the frequency by using governor motor load. Similarly, we can vary the load. Instead, we can vary a load or we can vary a frequency. Let's say because of this, once we turn, we can vary the load on each generator. Like when generator number 1 and 2 get synchronized, now by raising or lowering this, we can increase or decrease load of each generator. So we can sync the load of both generator similar, or if we want the synchronization in a such a way that one generator will take a 50% load, 75% load, and other generator will take a 25% load. This can be also done by this. So not necessarily that both generator will have a same load when during the synchronization. We can have adjustments such that if one generator will take a 75% load and one generator will take a 25, still they will run in synchronization condition. So this is given, and this bottom is engine control. Once we pull and stop, pull and turn and leave, engine will stop. So this is, and here is one more condition is your load condition, whether light load, heavy load, and the light load condition. So what it indicates, like heavy load means if the load is more than 40 kilowatt, more than a 50 kilowatt, then we have to take a heavy load. In case of once we select the heavy load, if one generator is running and we have selected heavy load, now what happens? The generator will analyze himself and get a prediction whatever the load is available. If it is having a good kilowatt available for the heavy load operation, it will allow and it will give indications we can run the next, we can start the load. But in case of if voltage is less or power is not available for starting the heavy load, then generator will automatically start another standby generator henceforth to take on load. So this is the synchronization and all about this. First procedure is to take this on, make voltage governor control by controlling the governor system we can have. So whatever the most important thing is, key first we have to synchroscope ka jo switch hai, on this switch we have to select which generator is incoming, G1, G2 or G3. Once we select that, the synchroscope lamp will start rotate, whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise we have to see. Once it is clockwise, it indicates incoming generator running fast. So in order to adjust, we have to adjust the governor motor, either if it is running fast then we have to lower, and if it is running slow then we have to raise the by means of a governor motor, either a governor motor of the generator number, incoming generator, right? Once we get the desired value, desired, that is synchroscope is running clockwise and slowly, not that too fast, right? And there are three lamp, the dark and bright lamp method is also given optional to the synchroscope. So in that two lamp, R and T, so two lamp will be blowing while CS is off. In that condition and that condition, the both generator are in phase. Similarly, when synchroscope is in 11 o'clock position, we have to just close the ACB of incoming generator and leave. We can, so now generator will come on load automatically and synchronize himself. Now if the we have to control the load on each generator manually, then we can raise or lower the governor motor, so we can control the load or kilowatt on each generator. Either we can share the load, one generator is having more or other generator we have to lower, then we can do that, or else we can do 50-50, 75-25% also is possible, like 60-40 or whatever the combination we want, we can adjust through a governor motor. Like there is also another condition is given, heavy load and light load. This is given in case of if we have to start one generator is running and other generator is on standby. What happen if we have to start the heavy load, like blast pump, then heavy load, once we press the heavy load button, what happen? The generator will try to analyze himself that whether 50 the heavy load condition, 40 to 50 kilowatt loads is load, 50 kilowatt load is a setter. If that much of kilowatt is available, that much of power is available, then it will give indications for starting. It will give any positive indications that we can start the load. But if not, then it will automatically start the standby generator in case to take the heavy load. This is one of the protection is a given. Like, and that's all. Thank you. All about that. So, okay.